Hello students, today we are going to start the fifth lecture of transmission of power. This topic is from the fourth unit of basics of mechanical engineering. So just have a look over what we have done in the previous lectures. We did the basic concept of the power transmission. We derived the formula for velocity ratio of simple belt drive. We practiced some numerical on the velocity ratio. And second lecture, we derived the formula for total length, and also we practiced some numerical problem on total length. And in the third lecture, we derived the tension ratio for the simple belt. And in the fourth lecture, we see the formula in the belt drive, and also we derived the formula for the centrifugal tension, and we have studied the centrifugal tension in the previous lecture. Now in the fifth lecture, we will see the maximum tension for the design of the belt material, and we will study what is initial tension, and we will see the condition for the maximum power transmission. So maximum Tmax, that is the maximum tension expression for the design of the belt material. So we have seen in the previous lecture that maximum tension in the belt, it can be the T1 max or it can be the T2 max, but in both the T1 max and T2 max, which is greater, T1 max is the greater because T1 is more than T2. So T1 plus TC is the T1 max, that is the maximum tension generated inside the material of the belt. So if sigma S, this is sigma S, S means strength, sigma S is the strength of the belt material, which is termed in the Newton per meter square, that you may studied in the intermediate, that what is stress. Stress is the force upon area. So and the unit of this, that is strength, is force is Newton, and per meter square is, it is area, unit of the area, this is unit of the force, so which is also known as a stress. So sigma stress generated inside the material will be the force applied to the area of the cross section. So sigma S is the maximum stress. Sigma S means if the force is increasing and as much increasing so that the material will break down. So at that time the stress generated, at that time the value of stress is known as the strength of the material. So we can see that this, if this is a cross section of the flat belt, this is the cross section of the flat belt, which thickness is T and the width is B. So what is the area of this section? This section area is B multiplied by T, and the tension is applying outward from the material, and the maximum tension is T1 max, and this maximum tension will be responsible for the failure of this belt material. So this force divided by the area must be less than the strength of the material. So for safe design of the belt material, the stress generated due to maximum tension must be less than or equal to strength of the belt material. So what is the maximum stress generated? That is the maximum force upon area should be less than or equal to strength of the material. This is a constant value. This is the materialistic property of the material. And this is stress generated because of tension, high tension. So this must be less than or equal to sigma S. So T1 max divided by BT, BT is the area, that should be less than or equal to sigma S. So we can find out the what is the value of T1 max, that what should be the value of T1 max. T1 max must be less than sigma S multiplied by B into T. For numerical solving, we can use only the equal sign, not these inequalities. So T1 max must be equal to sigma S multiplied by B into T. If the T1 max is more than this this value, if the T1 max is more than this value, then the material will break down. If the T1 max is less than this value, then material will not break down and working will be continue. Now the condition for the maximum power transmission capacity, I'm not going to derive the formula for this because the derivation for this this condition is not in your course. So T max for this the condition is that T max must be equal to three times of the centrifugal tension. So what is the centrifugal tension? M into V square. What is M? M is not the mass. M is the mass per unit length. We have studied this in the previous lecture. So this is equation number one. So T max equals to 3 multiplied by mv square. So V max equals to root of T max divided by 3m. Why it is V max? Here it is V, here it is V max. Why? Because T is maximum. If the T is, if we are taking the T, another T means T lesser the value, that is T, this is the T1 max. If we take the T2 max, then this will be V2 max. Okay, so this can be changed. If this will be changed, so V is directly proportional to T max. So this is equation number two. As we know that the T max equals to T1 plus TC. So if we put this value in this equation number one, so T max will be T1 plus TC. So T1 will be twice of centrifugal tension. So now the last topic is the initial tension. What is initial tension? We can see if we have a pulleys, two pulleys, and motor is not started yet. So at that time we have to wrap this bed over this pulleys. So at that time we need some tension to make this grip properly, make this grip very strong. This grip must be strong, because if motor is started at that time, if there is no proper grip, that belt can be fall down and that belt can be slipped over this pulley at starting. So to make the proper grip at starting of the motor, we need some initial tension in this belt. How we will provide this initial tension in this belt? We will provide this initial tension by using the length of the belt lesser than the length of the belt which is calculated from the formula. Means we have already see the formula for the length of the belt. If the formula if the value come out from the formula is 100 meter, then we should take about 98 meter of the belt actually, so that we can stretch the belt and wrap over this pulleys so that there is initial tension provided. So the formula for this initial tension, this is TU, this is TU. Formula for this initial tension is T1 plus T2 plus 2TC divided by 2. If we consider centrifugal tension, if the velocity of the belt is less than 8 meter per second, then TC will not be considered, means that this will be vanished or this can be zero. So that in that, so if the weld velocity is less than 8 meter per second, in that case the centrifugal tension will be neglected. So neglected means the centrifugal tension will be zero. So the formula for the initial tension will be T1 plus T2 by 2. So we have completed the belt drive, in which we have done so many numericals, so many derivations and some theory parts of the topic. So now you need to do some practice for numerical problem, as this is a most important topic for the numerical question for your exam point of view. And you just solve the numericals and share your answer on the Google Classroom, so that I can check the answers and I can ensure that you have active on the these video lectures and doing numericals and reading the notes. And from the next lecture we will start gear drive. This is a very important and very interesting topic of this unit. Then I want you to say that just subscribe the channel, so that you can get the video lectures, and so that I also need some feedback from your side, so that I can